Research Design Lab.
Hello everyone. In this video here, I will explain how to use this board as an Arduino shield which could be used to send and receive GSM text and GPRS data across the internet. This board has SIM900A modem. If you are familiar with this modem, you would know the modem works with a set of AT commands. These AT commands basically are fed through UART protocol, in other words serial data. By default you can communicate through hard serial or pin D0 and D1 of Arduino board. If required, you could also use soft serial by changing the padding in this area. That is, by default the padding is between 3 and 2. If soft serial is required, then you need to remove the padding between 3 and 2 and change it to 2 and 1 for both RX and TX connection. If you need some help with sample codes, you can visit our product page. Let's move to the power section now. I'll tell you about the power requirements later. Here you see a power button, and here there are some mail headers. Let me explain about these headers first. If a jumper is placed on ground in PK, then by default the GSM modem has been turned on. If these headers are kept open, then the only way to turn on this modem is by hitting the power on button. However, make sure you press and hold it for at least 1 second, just like how you turn on your cell phones. Parallel to ground and PK header, there is another pair of headers, Q2 and D9. Now if I remove my jumpers from ground and PK and place it on Q2 and D9, then you can turn on your modem in two ways. That is, either by pressing this power button or by giving a pulse of 3 seconds from high to low to D9 pin of your Arduino. This feature is useful where power saving is required. That is, the modem could be turned on only when it's required by adding a few lines of codes. Now regarding the power supply, basically GSM modems require high current during communication mode. Your USB power supply which you connect to your Arduino is not nearly enough to turn on this modem. So an external adapter of 12 volt and a minimum of 2 amperes of current rating needs to be connected to your Arduino board. I repeat, an external adapter connection is must while you are working on this shield. Also, there are 3 indicator LEDs on board: the power LED, the status LED and the network LED. The power indicator is on while your GSM is turned on. The status LED should also be on. If the status LED is toggling, then it means that the current is not enough for your GSM modem. Make sure you use a good quality 12 volt 2 amp adapter. The network indicator will keep toggling every alternate second. If these indicators are working accordingly, then your GSM modem is in the working condition. Also, you need to understand the fact that every time you power on your modem, the modem will take some time to register itself into the network, maybe around 10 to 15 seconds. So make sure you give appropriate delay in your code before you enter your AT commands into the modem. Apart from these things, there are a few other things on this board which you may be interested in, like how you can listen or talk to a person using the modem. For this purpose, you need to make a few connections on board. These two pins are for your mic input, next two pins are for your speakers. Please note the fact that this modem has only mono connection for audio, not stereo. Next here are few mail headers, TX, RX, ground and 5V. These connections can be used in case you are planning to use this modem as a GSM device for other controllers. However, make sure you connect 12V 2A source or an adapter with the same ratings to the VIN of the board. This 5V is an output header. You cannot use this header to supply voltage to the GSM modem. If you supply voltage to this header, there are chances you may damage your modem. Last but not the least, this here is the Arduino reset key. Basically resets your Arduino board and starts executing your code from the beginning. And these here are the replicas of your Arduino headers, as like your Arduino Uno R3 board. However, please note pin D0, D1, D2, D3 and D9 could be occupied by the GSM modem based on the padding and jumper settings, and respective pins cannot be used for other purpose. There's one last but obvious fact. You need to place a fully functional SIM card on the SIM card slot provided on the bottom of the board. Thank you for watching. I hope this product presentation was helpful for you to know how to work on this board. If you have any queries, do post it on the comment section below.